What's going on, guys? My name's Theo Atrix, and today I'm presenting my complete melee combat training guide. Throughout this video, I'll show you how the bonuses work, I'll talk a bit about gear and weaponry, and what types of items you should focus on getting, and then everything you need to know about the best training methods in the game, and I'll also give a little summary of bossing and the pets from combat towards the end. Starting off with your bonuses and levels, anything revolving around attack in old school RuneScape correlates to your accuracy. It doesn't change how much you hit, but it increases how often you will hit. Increasing your attack level also allows you to wear more weapons, which gives you an increased attack bonus. Your strength level solely changes your max hit, and there's no change to your accuracy at all. You can also wear some extra weapons by having a higher strength level, and your strength bonus mainly comes from your weapon, but there is a lot of gear that also boosts your attack and strength bonuses as well. Your defense level lowers the chance of you getting hit, but it doesn't change anything to the max hit that you'll take. Increasing your defense level also increases the armor that you can wear, which gives you more of a defense bonus, making you get hit far less often with the higher level gear. Now I'd like to talk about weaponry, and in almost all cases of training combat in old school, a weapon that has a high attack speed is usually the best choice. Slow weapons usually hit a bit higher, but faster weapons attack more consistently and overall will give you a better experience rate and faster damage per second. At low levels, all of these scimitars are the best for training your melee combat. In terms of training your attack strength and defense, your attack level takes slight priority over strength at lower levels, since you need to unlock those better weapons. All the way up to level 40, the Rune Scimitar is the best for you to use. However, members unlock the Brine Saber, which actually gives a slightly better slash and strength bonus in comparison to the Rune Scimitar. It does cost a little bit more, but for those that have the money, this can speed up your training at a lower level. Once you reach level 50 attack and level 50 strength, you can start wearing granite items. There's a few new granite weapons in the game, and the best one available is the Granite Hammer. It is quite expensive, so the Granite Longsword is another great option at this level. If you reach level 55 Slayer, the best in-slot item at 50 attack is actually the Leaf-Bladed Sword, and it gives a far better attack bonus than the Granite Hammer, but not quite a higher strength bonus. However, it does give a much better attack bonus, making it better than the Granite Hammer for training, and a lot cheaper as well. Once you reach level 60 attack, you unlock Dragon Weaponry, and the Dragon Scimitar is what you should be aiming for, as it's the best weapon for you to train with at this level, and it's a lot cheaper than a lot of the other weapons. Wearing the Dragon Scimitar needs Monkey Madness. And for those that haven't completed Monkey Madness, there are a couple of options available that still give decently good bonuses. Once your attack and strength level equal 130 by adding them both together, you're allowed to access the Warrior Guild, and inside the Warriors Guild, you can get Defenders. These Defenders require a defense level to wear, however they give very high attack and strength bonuses, as well as defensive bonuses, making them a very important shield slot item for when you're training your melee combats. As soon as you can enter the Warrior Guild, I'd recommend grinding out to the Dragon Defender, because overall that's going to do a huge difference to your XP rates. Once you reach level 70 attack, you unlock a few more options. For training your attack and defense above level 70, I highly recommend using the Abyssal Whip, but for training your strength, you have a few different options. The Sarodoman Sword is a very cheap strength training option, the Abyssal Bludgeon is the best two-handed strength training weapon, and then once you reach level 75 attack, you unlock the best melee training weapon in the game, the Garazi Rapier. Also at level 75, you unlock the Abyssal Tentacle, the Blessed Sara Sword, and the Staff of the Dead, which are all very powerful melee weapons. However, the Abyssal Tentacle and the Blessed Sara Sword both are degradable, therefore it costs quite a lot to attack with it. Now I'd like to talk about armor, and when you're choosing your armor, you always need to take note of the attack style of your opponent. Against monsters or players that used melee or ranged, metal armor and shields will give you the highest defense bonus. Against magic, dragonhide and other ranged gear provides the highest magic defense. When training, you should try focusing on items that will boost your attack bonus and your strength bonus. Of course, your weapon is the most important for these bonuses, but your armor and everything else you wear really does contribute to your overall damage and XP rates. I'd like to quickly go over each item slot to give you guys the best in slots, plus a few different alternatives. I'm not going to go into depth because that would take a lot of time, but I'll very quickly list through them. In terms of headgear, the best thing you should go out of your way to get is the Helm of Nader's Knot. The Serpentine Helm gives the same strength bonus, however gives a higher defense bonus than the Nader's Knot, and you should always know that the Slayer Helmet or the Black Mask will always give the best damage boost on a Slayer task. In terms of body armor, the highest strength bonus comes from the Fighter Torso and the Bandos Chestplate. However, the Bandos Chestplate has a far better defense bonus than the Fighter Torso. In the leg slot, the only items that give a strength bonus there are the Bandos Tassets and the Obsidian Plate Legs. I highly suggest using the Obsidian Plate Legs, and once you can afford it, the Bandos Tassets are your best in slot. In the shield slot, all of the defenders are the best for the highest damage per second. The Dragon Fire Shield gives a high strength bonus, and at very low levels, when you haven't unlocked a defender, the Zamorak Book or the Obsidian Shield both give decent bonuses for training. In the cape slot, the Infernal Cape from the Inferno is now the best in slot cape in the game. Second is the Fire Cape from the Fight Caves. Also, the Obsidian Cape is pretty good at a low level for the defense bonuses. In the next slot, the Amulet of Torture is the best in slot, but the Amulet of Fury and the Amulet of Glory provide good attack bonuses and some strength bonuses as well. All of the gloves from the Recipe for Disaster quest are the best in your hand slot. However, the Regen Bracelet, Granite Gloves, and the Combat Bracelet are all alternatives if you haven't started or completed the quest. In terms of your boot slot, climbing boots are awesome for very low levels, giving a nice boost in your strength bonus, and the best in slot are the Primordial Boots with Dragon Boots in second. In your ring slot, the best item for training is the Berserker Ring Imbued from the Nightmare Zone. I spoke earlier about Obsidian, and with level 60 defense you can wear the whole Obsidian set, and it gives you a 10% damage and accuracy boost to the melee Obsidian weapons. You can also wear the Berserker Necklace to increase that boost, but those items are also good on their own. Each one of the Obsidian pieces gives a strength bonus, and the cost in comparison to Bandos is very cheap. Now I'd like to go over how to train your combat XP very quickly at a low level, and that is via questing. As a member, you can complete the Waterfall quest, which has absolutely no requirements and will get you from level 1 to 30 attack and strength instantly. There's a range of other quests available that give huge XP rewards with very low requirements as a member. The most notable ones are the Fight Arena and the Trinome Village quest. As a free-to-play player, you still do have some options for massive XP rewards. The Vampire Slayer quest can be done at a very low level for a 5,000 attack XP reward, and then the Dragon Slayer quest gives massive XP rewards after completing. At a low level, there's so many places to train in RuneScape. In this segment, I'm going to go over about 5 to 10 different methods that are suitable for fast XP, and some of these will give you a decent amount of money. As a free-to-play player, the best place to start training is at the Chickens and Cows in Lumbridge. Once you're above around level 30 combat, you can head over to the Hill Giants in the Edgeville dungeon. A recent addition to old school RuneScape brought Obor, the Hill Giant boss, where by killing the Hill Giants, you get a key that gives you access to fighting Obor. This really spices up your training, and Obor is killable with melee, but be very careful because he is quite powerful. Once you reach a higher combat level, you can attack moss giants in the Varrox sewers, and from the moss giants you can get a mossy key to fight the moss giant boss Bryophyta. And this boss, surprisingly, is easier than Obor, and both Obor and Bryophyta have very lucrative drops for low level accounts and give you a taste of what bossing is like in RuneScape. Free to play players can also take advantage of the Stronghold of Security. There's flesh crawlers on the second level, which are great for low levels. There's spiders for some more AFK kind of training, Ankus for a bit of money, and the last free-to-play training spot I'd like to mention is the Ogress Warriors, located at Corsair Cove. These guys drop a lot of rune items and high-value drops, but these are mainly for players above level 80 in melee combat. As a low-level member, you have access to a way larger variety of options. Rock Crabs, just north of Relica, are an easily accessible training spot for low levels, and Rock Crabs are very weak targets, with a lot of hit points. An addition unique to old school is Sand Crabs, located just south of the Hosidius House on Zaya. Sand Crabs are very similar to Rock Crabs, with a very low combat level and higher hit points than Rock Crabs. The experiments, they have very low attack bonuses, and they have 100 hit points. This is an excellent place to train at a low level, but experiments have zero valuable drops, so if you want something that is a little bit profitable at a low level, you can kill Chaos Druids at Edgeville Dungeon, Taverly Dungeon, or the Chaos Druid Tower. These guys drop a lot of high-level herbs, which will really add up at a low level. The most efficient way to train your combat levels in RuneScape in terms of going for the max cape is to train your combat through Slayer. It's recommended to start Slayer when you have at least level 70 combat in order to use the Fairy Slayer Master and have access to good gear and teleports. The damage and accuracy bonus from the Slayer Helmet and the Black Mask make your Slayer tasks great melee XP at the same time as training the Slayer skill, and a lot of the Slayer monsters have very valuable drops, meaning you'll make a lot of money going through to level 99 Slayer, and on your journey to 99 Slayer, you're pretty much guaranteed to get 99s in a lot of the combat stats. Some Slayer tasks cannot efficiently be done with melee only, but in the long run, if you're going for the fastest overall total level, the best way to train is consistently through Slayer. Now I'd like to go over the methods that give the fastest XP in the game, and the first one is the Nightmare Zone. To partake in the Nightmare Zone, you need at least 5 of the quests completed that have bosses. I also recommend having at least around level 60 combat before you take part in the Nightmare Zone, otherwise the XP rates are not worth your time. The thing about the Nightmare Zone is you have access to overloads and absorption potions, which negates the cost of super combat potions, boosts your stats more, and you also don't need prayer potions due to the absorptions. The herb boxes can be done for profit over time, and the Nightmare Zone is something that can be done very AFK as well. In order to get the fastest melee combat XP at the Nightmare Zone, you need to look out for the Power Surge power-up. Pairing that power-up with special attack items like the Granite Maul or the Dragon Claws, it's possible to get well over 100k XP per hour. Wearing full Darok at the Nightmare Zone and lowering your hit points to 1 using the Locator Orb or the Dwarven Rock Cake is another very common and fast way to train your combat. On top of all those benefits, doing some of your training at the Nightmare Zone will allow you to imbue some of your rings and other items. Another training method that uses the Darok set is killing the monkey guards located on Ape Atoll. A very fast way there is using the Ape Atoll teleport on the regular spellbook, and that takes you literally next to the training spot. There's an altar right next to them as well, which allows you to stay here pretty much endlessly while using stat boosting prayers as well. Now I'd like to go over some AFK training spots, and the first one is Ammonite Crabs, which are unlocked after completing the Bone Voyage quest. These guys have the same stats as Experiments, they're level 25 and have 100 hit points. They also have a very low max hit, meaning you won't need to bring much food at all. There's a lot of spots you can stand to stay at this spot AFK for 10 minutes at a time. After 10 minutes, the crabs will stop reacting to you standing there and they won't attack you, keeping you in combat. Another very AFK training spot is at Bandits, and by using a Sarodomen or Zamorak item, these guys will stay aggressive to you forever. Pairing Guthans with a Sarodomen or Zamorak item, you can stay AFK here for up to 20 minutes until you'll stop attacking and eventually log out. There's also the tent nearby that you can exchange banknotes for regular items, so if you bring noted food with you, you can stay here forever. Now I have a few money makers that come out of melee combat, and the first one is Revenants. The main disadvantage of Revenants right now is that they're very crowded with PKs. The whole Revenant cave is multi-combat, and within the cave there are Revenants ranging from very low to very high combat levels. Because of this, Revenants can be done at any level, and can be very profitable for any account. Wearing the Bracelet of Aetherum, Revenants cannot deal any damage to you whatsoever. The profit really depends on how much you get PK'd and how lucky you get on the drop table, but currently Revenants are one of the most lucrative methods in the game. Another monster that makes quite a bit of money over time is the Green Dragons, and these are located throughout the wilderness and are only level 79 combat. Every kill you get the guaranteed drop of the Dragon Bones and the Green Dragon Hides, and if you pick those up every kill, you can easily make up to 500k coins per hour. At level 75 Slayer, you unlock the Gargoyles, and these are commonly killed on alt accounts, but can be killed on your account for great profits, and you can kill these quite AFK for a consistent amount of profit. Gargoyles do have a fairly high defense level, meaning you won't get very high XP rates when you're fighting them, but a lot of their drops are noted, so that means you'll be able to stay there indefinitely without going to the bank at all. The next part of this video is the bosses you can fight with only melee. The two free-to-play bosses, Obor and Bryophyta, are both pretty simple and relatively straightforward bosses. Sadly, pets are not available in free-to-play. However, these guys drop other unique items like the Hill Giant Club or Bryophyta's Essence, which can be turned into Bryophyta's staff. Moving into the members' bosses, there's a new boss available in Old School RuneScape that wasn't available back in RuneScape 2, known as Skatizo. The giant mole, which lives under Falador Park, is a great monster to start trying if you'd like to start getting into bossing. Flinching the Chaos Elemental is another great option, and a lot of the other wilderness bosses are also meleeable bosses. Each one of these also have a pet variant that drops at a rate of 1 in 2000, which is very common for a pet. The Verax set is the most powerful on most of the wilderness bosses and requires 70 attack, strength, and defense to wear the whole thing. Two out of the four God Wars bosses are killable with melee. Krill Tsutaroth is the first one, and General Grador, which is slightly weaker than Krill Tsutaroth. There's also a lot of Slayer bosses that you can kill with melee. First off, the Grotesque Guardians, which are a Gargoyle boss unlocked at 75 Slayer. There's the Abyssal Sire, which is the boss version of the Abyssal Demons, and this requires level 85 Slayer. There's Cerberus, which is a Hellhound boss requiring 91 Slayer, and is one of the most profitable bosses per hour in the game. The Thermonuclear Smoke Devil is another boss killed with only melee and requires level 93 Slayer to kill. Finally, the highest level boss out of all of these that I've said is the Corporal Beast, and this one requires above level 90 in all of the melee combat stats in order to be effective in a team. The Corporal Beast has a drop that is well over 500 million coins right now, and players camp at Corp for weeks and months trying to land that drop. So that is my 1-99 melee combat training guide. A couple of final notes. Firstly, that you can train your defense using long range on Chinchompas or using ancient magics on defensive casting, and this actually gives more experience per hour in defense than using melee. One other quick point is that strength can be trained at barbarian fishing without training your hit points at all. So that's the end of my 1-99 melee combat guide. If you learned something interesting today, be sure to leave a like on this video. If you're new to my channel, be sure to subscribe. If you have any training spots that I haven't mentioned that you think other people should know about, be sure to type them into the comments and I'll like and pin some of the ones that I think are good. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.